This video clip explains the custom settings of the new Door Window Stamp 19 label, introduced in ARCHICAD 19. As a starting note, please watch the three clips in this playlist covering custom settings of labels, since they cover many of the custom settings and behavior common to several label types. This clip covers only settings specific to this label type and not covered in the above-mentioned clips. The Door Window Stamp 19 label is a new label type in ARCHICAD 19, which displays various geometry and other information about doors and windows. When you select this label type in the Label Settings dialog, the Custom Settings panel contains four pages. The first page is the Content Setup page. For the explanation of the main fields in the Settings page, please watch the clip in this playlist titled Label Custom Settings, Content Setup. There are 14 parameters available as content in this label type. Out of these, the Show Reveal Dimensions and Show Sill Height parameters are relevant only for windows, while the Show Egress Dimensions and Show Threshold Height parameters are relevant only for doors. Each parameter has a checkbox, and the parameter is displayed in the label when its corresponding checkbox is checked in the list. By default, four parameters are checked: Show ID, Show Wall Hole Dimensions, Show Sill Height, and Show Threshold Height. Also, when a parameter checkbox is checked, its related parameters also appear. You can access these by clicking the right pointing arrow in the line of the parameter. Every parameter has a parameter name field. This defines the text that will appear in the parameter name column, the left column of the label text block. By default, for most parameters, this field is filled with a default value. Additionally, every parameter has a value field. By using this, you can select or specify what value will appear in the parameter volume column, the right column of the label text block. For most parameters, there are two possible choices in this field. The first choice is the automatic option. Or measured value option in some of the parameters. This will return the corresponding parameter of the labeled element. The other choice for the value field is the custom text option. When you select this, a custom value field appears in which you can specify the custom value that will appear for that parameter. Please note that the last two parameters are custom text 1 and custom text 2, so for these, there is no value field. A custom value field is the only option here. Some specifics need to be mentioned about some of the parameters. In the case of the Show ID parameter, the four possible choices for the value field are Compact Element ID, Master ID, Full Element ID, and Custom. For the full explanation of these options, please watch the previous clip in this playlist titled New Label Types, Composite or Profile Name Label. In the case of the Show Wall Hole Dimensions, Show Unit Dimensions, Show Reveal Dimensions, and Show Egress Dimensions parameters, there is an additional parameter called Value Separator. In this field, you can specify the character or characters that separate the width and height values of these dimension parameters. For the show sill height parameter, there are two additional parameters. The measured to parameter lets you set the vertical position the sill height will be measured from. Its anchor option currently gives the same result as the wall base option. They'll return the height of the sill relative to the base level of the wall. The current story option will return the height of the sill relative to the level of the current story. Please note that the value this parameter displays in the label is by default reduced by the value of the subfloor thickness value of the window. Thus, displaying a lesser value. If you check the Reduce by Subfloor Thickness checkbox for the label, it will reduce the level the sill height is measured from by the value of the subfloor thickness. So, it will counteract the effect of the above-mentioned automatic value reduction. Thus, the value displayed when this checkbox is checked will be higher than the value when it is unchecked. Finally, the Show Material parameter has a material field, which has four possible values. The first three are wood, aluminum, and plastic. Alternately, you can select the Custom option and specify the material in the Custom Value field that appears below this field. The second page of the Custom Settings panel is the General Settings page. For the full explanation of all parameters in this Settings page, please watch the clip in this playlist titled Label Custom Settings, General Settings. The third page of the Custom Settings panel is the First Line Text Style page. Here you can specify custom settings for the first line of text appearing in the label's text block. To do this, check the Override Text Style of First Line checkbox. With the checkbox checked, the first line of text will be displayed with the settings specified here instead of the settings specified in the Text Style panel of the dialog. All settings here will affect the whole first line of text. With the large button on the left, you can set the justification for the first line to left, center, and right. To its right, you can set the pen and font type for the first line of text. In the second row from left to right, you have fields to set the font size, then buttons to switch the text to bold, italic, underline, and strike through. In the last line, you can use the line spacing field to keep line spacing between the first and second line of text on automatic. Or you can switch to the custom option and specify a value in the field to its right that becomes enabled when the custom option is selected. The fourth and last page of the Custom Settings panel is the Information page. It displays the name of the label type, Door Window Stamp 19, as well as a green icon for all element types for which the label type is available and displays valid data. This includes the door and window element types.